are going to talk about roots.
We are?
Yes, we are.
Oh, okay.
Not just roots.
There's more?
Oh, why, yes, there is more. Healthy
roots. This could
roots,
be good.
Deep roots, but more importantly, the anchor roots that come out of the stalk above ground on corn plants. If you listen to the seed corn salesman, he'll say, oh, you get those anchor roots coming out above the ground. He goes, that's a good genetic. That's letting you know that that plant has the ability to anchor itself down so it can stand wind, so it can bypass a storm, so it has standability, so it's a good solid plant.
That means it's going to be a good high BRIX plant.
Absolutely, yes. Possibly not. What we found is, look at these roots. When you see them growing down, number one, if they're there, it's because the below ground roots have run into a table, a hard pan, and they started to go lateral. They didn't get the depth to create the stability, so here come the above ground. When you see those roots go below, and I'm going to need you here in just a second, Doc.
I'm with you, almost.
Yeah, don't go away now. When you see these roots, and you can do it with a shovel, go down and out, it tells you that maybe that plant isn't getting as much as what it would like. It's worried about tipping over, so here come the above ground anchor roots. Looking at these anchor roots, and this happens in all types of soil, but if you've used chemicals fairly regularly in the past, you may see these anchor roots look like they have rheumatoid arthritis. If they're growing crooked and not getting to the ground, probably a fair bit of chemical in that ground. When we see this, it tells many different stories. We can tell a whole different story when we start checking what sugar daddy...
What's this?
Caribbean Joe here does with the refractometer. So if you were to see an impaired plant, I don't get paid enough for this. Should get hazard pay.
You should, but
if
you won't.
If you see a root that is impaired or compromised,
yes,
does the above ground portion of that plant just sing melodic harmony and health?
Absolutely not. This plant will register as a low BRIX plant on the refractometer, and yes, I'm aware that the eyepiece is on the side. Some of you are thinking, like, he doesn't even know which end this is. It's a joke, okay? And so because of that, yes, it is easily testable with the refractometer saying, okay, there's a problem right here. And there's a problem, too, because think about this. The corn plant, you know, has this mind of its own, and it wants its roots to go deep. It doesn't go that deep. Everybody knows, I think everybody knows that among plants with a deep root system, corn doesn't rank that high. They have relatively shallow roots. So relatively speaking, that means they're not going to go that deep, but that doesn't mean that they want to go shallow. And so when you have a root from a corn plant hitting hard pan, such as this table is demonstrating right now, the roots do not stop at the hard pan. If they did, that's as far as the roots wanted or needed to go. But the fact that they want to go deeper but can't, and then do a 90 degree turn and start heading off in two opposite directions, or at least flat along the hard pan, this is a very strong message that the plant wants to go deeper but can't. So if all the roots stopped, we would conclude, and rightly so, that the plant was done growing its roots. But the corn plant does not in these situations. Therefore, that's an indication that something is wrong. If that's not enough to convince, and there are these ways of determining it without using a refractometer, but if you do not see that or wish to test it anyway, I invite you to do so. pick up a refractometer, get one of those leaves, and you're really only going to need one corn leaf. You don't need that much in order to test it. You would usually not be sacrificing a plant, especially if the corn has multiple leaves, but go ahead and maybe take half the leaf. Whatever needs to be done, squeeze it, get an idea of what the BRIX levels are. I'm going to warn you ahead of time, it's going to be a little low when you see this condition on the in the corn. And so, correct, you are correct. Once again, Glenn, you are correct. So there are problems
music
with that corn plant.
Music to my ears.
You're welcome.
Now, this information doesn't matter if you're tilling, no tilling, or anything in between.
Correct.
It's about identifying a problem.
See.
Looking for the solution. Mm-hmm. And we talked about the penetrometer in many different videos. Most microbes can't withstand 200 PSI. Most feeder roots can't push through more than 300 PSI. And what we found ideal is 100 to 150 PSI. And as deep as you can get and as deep as you want those roots to get, that will invite those roots and the microbes to grow, to flourish. And all of a sudden, when those roots grow as deep and as wide as they want because there's no compaction, all of a sudden you see what you want to see.
The BRIX goes up.
Yeah, because it's awful hard to have a good top on a plant if you have horrible roots or compromised roots.
They're related to one another.
Huh.
Yeah.
Okay, so a short little clip. I hope this has been beneficial. Dr. Tom Dykstra, you can reach him at... Or view his, he has other videos that you can view.
You can reach me and check out DykstraLabs.com. You can give me a call. I'm sure I would love to talk to you. Now, as far as the YouTube videos are concerned, simply just do a search for Thomas Dykstra. And you can take a look and view as many of the videos as you want, or as few as you want. Either way, it's okay. I'm not going to be following you or...
For Glenn at SoilWorks and Dr. Tom Dykstra, we hope this information has been helpful, and we hope to see you watching another video in the near future. Thank you.
Thank you.